Oh my god, it's cold. This is not mine. I got a sandwich. I believe it's a ham, salami, lettuce, and tomatoes. And yeah, and also got a food. By the way, $5 for this. Feeling so much better. So this is the morning the day after. Me and my friends didn't get into our Airbnb house until 5 a.m. in the morning. We were so tired. So that flight was absolutely nightmare. It was the worst I have ever experienced. Long story short, when we got to the Orlando Airport, the flight supposed to take off at like 6:30 p.m. They would keep delaying the flight like half an hour, and then another half an hour, like back to back. And there was like total amount of four or five hours. It was absolutely terrible. So, but anyways, we're here. We made it. Now we're in Yosemite National Park. And we're going to spend time here the entire day today. And then tomorrow we're going to San Francisco, downtown San Francisco, and then LA. When I travel, I normally have coffee, just a cup of coffee in the morning. I skip breakfast, like completely skip breakfast, because I know during the day I'm gonna be eating like an idiot. Talking about breakfast, guy, I used to be a really, really huge breakfast guys. Like I literally wake up and have breakfast before I would do anything else, because everybody keeps saying, you know, like breakfast is the most important meal of the day. You can't skip breakfast. If you skip breakfast, you gain weight, and let's go on. And then, you know, and once I realized that, you know, breakfast is not that special to you guys, because when you want to lose fat, you want your blood sugar stable, you want your insulin levels stable, and once you eat, you kind of, you know, spike up your insulin level, and you won't lose fat that way. Starting off, you don't have to skip it like entirely, right? Trying to push it like a little bit far back. Let's say you normally have breakfast like 8 a.m. Try to have it like 9 a.m. or 10 a.m. So that way you give your body a sort of time to keep your blood sugar, to keep your insulin level kind of stable longer, 1 or 2 hours. Now on the other hand, if you eat some sort of thing like early in the morning, like first thing in the morning, so you have your glycogen into your body, you have your carb in, your body will prefer use that energy over protein, over store fat that you have to use as energy, because when you eat something, you have your glycogen and everything, and then your body will use that first every single time. The point is, you will lose fat only when your glycogen in your body or your carbohydrates is completely depleted. And once it's depleted, your body will, you know, use the stored fat that you have as a sort of energy. Let me know if that makes sense. Alright guys, I'll quit running my mouth. I'll show you where we're going. See you next clip.
Excuse me, sir. So what do you think about Yosemite? I'll see you later.
First thing, I got a chicken salad, and when you order a salad, every single time order a dressing on the side because you want to control how much calories you put in. There's at least, I would say, 20 grams of fats in this, so well over we're looking at 400 calories in just a little container. It's crazy. So next time you order a salad, ask the dressing on the side. That's a tip. Steak medium rare, baked potatoes, and steamed veggies inside, on the side.
These are my Adirondacks.